Hey everyone, good afternoon. It's Emily here from Tandem Speech Therapy in Austin. And if we haven't met already and you haven't heard about Playing with Purpose, Playing with Purpose is a series that I write on my blog. And it's really designed for me to share ideas for you and give you tips to convert play and the everyday routines that you're already engaging in with your child into moments where they can learn and where their speech and language skills benefit. So like I mentioned, I write this as a series on my blog, and I also offer it as a service. I call it Playing with Purpose Coaching. So if you're located here in Austin, Texas, then you can contact me about coming to your home. I do Playing with Purpose Coaching for kids of all different ages. Hey, Catherine. Work with you in your home and teach you all different kinds of tips and tricks to use when you're playing during the stuff that you and your children love to engage with the most. And I also offer Playing with Purpose Coaching as like a video chat service, kind of like I'm talking to y'all today, or by phone. So if you have any questions about that, you can check out my website and contact me, and I would love to talk to you about incorporating that into your life. So like I said, today for Playing with Purpose, we're gonna be talking about bubbles. So before I get into the tips, I'm just gonna share two of my favorite bubble products, I guess. So this thing, if you search for it like on Amazon and you search for bubbles, so like bubbles but with an F, this is a super cool no spill bubble container. So it's great for me as a speech therapist who travels. I don't have to worry about it tipping over in the car or in my bag, getting things all sticky. But it's also great at home because if you have it on the carpet or on your sofa and your child accidentally knocks it over, it's not going to be a big deal. Every once in a while it leaks, but if you're careful and you only fill it to where they suggest and the lid's on nice and tight, it shouldn't spill. And the other bubble thing that I love, they're called Super Miracle Bubbles. And these bubbles are super cool because they are like long lasting. So the bubble liquid is a little bit thicker. I don't know, maybe it has glue or something in it. But when you blow them, you can actually catch them on the end of your finger and they'll stay. And then if you get super lucky, you can sort of catch bubbles together and they will all attach to each other. And it just makes for lots of cool opportunities for language building. If you check out my Playing with Purpose post on bubbles on the blog, you can see a photo of that. So now we are going to get into my tips for Playing with Purpose. So the first one that I want to talk to you about is eye contact and then subsequently joint attention. So eye contact is one of the first and earliest forms of communication that kids use. You might have noticed it when your baby was an infant, a newborn, and you are feeding him or her, and they look at you and you look at him, and that communication, that super early communication. And joint attention is also another really important early form of communication that we have to help kids foster. And joint attention is, it's basically exactly what it sounds. It's attending to two different things jointly. So you might notice this in your kids. Let's say you're sitting on the floor playing with them and your child is putting blocks into a shape sorter, and they are putting the shapes in, watching the toy, then they pause and they glance up and they look at you, and then they go back to what they're doing. So that's joint attention. So one way that we can develop eye contact and joint attention for kids is what I would do is I would take my bubbles and I would blow the bubbles towards the child. Ooh, they're not working very well this afternoon. And then I would wait. And waiting gives your child an opportunity to initiate or start a communication with you, sort of without you prompting or asking them to communicate with you in some way. So one thing to look for is maybe your child is very young and they haven't developed words yet. So if your child looks at you or looks at the bubble wand or the bubble bottle, I would take that as an early form of communication and say something, oh, it looks like you want more bubbles. I'm gonna blow more bubbles. And you're rewarding that eye contact. And eye contact is also really important for kids learning to imitate. And we know that children have to have good imitation skills to develop speech. So they watch our mouth and listen to how we talk. And then they figure out how to move their mouth the same way that we did. Another thing that you can do is take your bubble wand and blow a bubble and then catch the bubble on the end of the wand. So let's pretend they're And then what I'm going to do is hold the bubble wand up by my eyes. I do this with lots of toys, but bubbles is a great one. And that's just going to encourage your child to look at you. So as soon as they make eye contact with you, then I reward that communication behavior in some way. Maybe you pop the bubble. Maybe you blow it over towards them. And then I would always pair, you know, that with some kind of verbal praise, really specific verbal praise. So I could say something like, oh, I really like how you looked at me. Or, oh, I like how you looked at the bubble. That told me you want me to blow the bubble. Okay, so that is eye contact and joint attention. So the next thing that bubbles is really great for is working on breath support. And breath support is very important, particularly for kids that are a little bit older, to help with speech clarity. And so that's how well your speech is understood when you're combining words together. So one really fun thing to do is maybe you have an exercise ball or yoga ball at your house. And what you can do is sit your child on top of the ball and let them try to blow bubbles while they're sitting on top of the ball. And that's gonna be super great work for their abdominal muscles. Their abdominal muscles are really going to have to engage. If you think about, you've probably done this yourself before when you sit on the ball. In order to keep your balance, you really engage your core and you engage your abdominal muscles. So when you're engaging your abdominal muscles and working on that blowing, you're working on breath support. You can also, if your child is having trouble blowing bubbles because they don't have enough breath support yet, another thing that you could do is take cotton balls and set them on a table and start by having them blow the cotton balls across the table. And you can even, if you're talking about it in the context of bubbles, you can pretend the cotton balls are bubbles. And that's just gonna be a little bit easier for them to blow than the bubbles to start. Bubbles are a great activity to help kids develop action words and different kinds of vocabulary. So there are words like pop and blow. Want, like I want bubbles. And then there are all different kinds of descriptor words. We call them location descriptor words or called prepositions. So we can talk about how the bubbles go up, 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 and how the bubbles go down, down, down. And maybe you put the wand in the bottle and you take the wand out of the bottle. And then you can talk about where you see the bubbles blowing. If you're using these super miracle bubbles and they land somewhere, you can say, oh, maybe the bubble is under the table or the bubble is on the chair. So those are great vocabulary terms to work on and help kids develop. Bubbles are great for turn taking. Lots of toys that we have for kids are great for turn taking, but I think I mentioned this in my last Facebook Live, but turn taking is, again, an important skill for kids to develop. And when they take turns in toys and learn how to do that during play, which is just a natural situation and scenario for kids to be in, it helps them learn how to take turns and build their conversational skills. So early on, we set kids up for taking turns during play, and then we can teach them how to take turns in a game, like a simple game. Maybe they're really young, Candyland, Chutes and Ladders, and then kids develop and play different games as they get older. Hey, Brooke. Hey, Yamila. Thanks for tuning in today. Like I said, that early turn-taking will eventually help them develop a good turn-taking skill for conversation, and that's how we communicate with each other as adults. So when you're doing turn-taking with bubbles, you can model my turn and your turn for kids, and the more that we model and demonstrate skills for kids, the more that they're going to learn it and incorporate it into their own language and be able to do it on their own. And the last thing I want to share with you today is about using bubbles for pointing. So I wrote a blog post a couple of weeks ago about pointing that you can find. And one of the activities I suggest is bubbles. And so just a few basics about pointing. So kids usually develop pointing. Pointing is a gesture. Kind of like waving high, pointing is a gesture. And kids will start to develop pointing somewhere in the 7 to 15 month range, and it changes, and there are a couple of different kinds of pointing that you can read about in the post. And we know from a bunch of research that kids who use gestures early on, like pointing, develop better language skills as they get older. So bubbles is a super great way to model pointing. One thing you can do is just practice popping the bubbles. And so that's going to get the child in the habit of pointing, even if they're not necessarily like pointing to request something, but they're using that index finger to point and pop the bubbles. And you can also just sort of model the use of pointing to get somebody's attention or to direct somebody's attention at it. So we imagine the bubble swimming through the air, and I might point at the bubble and say, "Look, I see a bubble," or "Watch me, I'm going to pop the bubble." And all while I'm modeling that language, I'm also modeling the gesture and the behavior. So that is all I have for y'all today on bubbles and a little bit extra on pointing. You can find all this information on the Tandem Speech Therapy website, which is www.tandemspeechtherapy.com. And again, if you're a parent or a caregiver watching this and you're interested in some Playing with Purpose coaching, you can contact me via the website, or you can also reach me by phone at 512-814-6660. So thank you all for tuning in today. I hope everyone has a great rest of your Friday and a wonderful weekend. I will see you next time. Bye.